We're hitting the city.
And you're coming with us.
We're here in Toronto at the Allen Gardens Conservatory visiting the Winter Flower Show.
Hoje trazemos a um sítio cheio de plantas e flores que, mesmo sendo inverno, atrai milhares de pessoas. Allen Gardens é um espaço onde muitos procuram conhecer o que de melhor a natureza tem para nos oferecer, mais que não seja paz. Entre os mais variados tipos de flores, existem plantas de todos os géneros.
As you're walking through this Edwardian era conservatory, which is over a century old, all the flowers and plants bring you to a peaceful state, a place where you can learn, grow and feel close to Mother Nature.
Este lugar está aberto todos os dias, com diferentes tipos de eventos consoante as estações do ano. Desta vez, trazemos-vos a edição de inverno.
The Winter Flower Show was running from December 2nd till January 9th this year. The displays were festive and complemented the holiday season well. There were hidden reindeer, swans, and lights that were intertwined within the flowers and plants.
Dentro deste jardim botânico existem 6 espaços diferentes, cada um deles dedicado a um determinado tipo de flores e plantas. Desde orquídeas a camélias, plantas tropicais e exóticas, de tudo um pouco, espalhado pelos canteiros.
The domed ceiling of the palm house acts as an entryway to the rest of the greenhouses. It features many palms, tropical vines and colored seasonal plants. As you walk through, you enter the cool temperate house, which has many camélias, jasmine and plants from the other side of the world, including Australia and the Mediterranean. Passing through, you will find ponds, turtles and fish along the way. The arid house has a large display of unusual cacti of all different shapes, sizes and colors. The two tropical houses have a wide range of plants, including beautiful orchids. The last greenhouse, the tropical landscape house, offers gingers, hibiscus and green jade vines, which are often used in spas and for relaxation.
Há milhares de anos que as plantas têm um papel absolutamente importante na saúde humana. Era, aliás, nas plantas que se procurava a cura medicinal de várias doenças. Depois de muito interesse e estudo por parte de cientistas nesse tipo de tratamentos medicinais ao longo dos anos, surgiu, por exemplo, a aspirina. Hoje são muitas as farmacêuticas que investem tempo e dinheiro na pesquisa de mais potenciais características medicinais em plantas. É importante lembrar que mais de 25% das medicações são baseadas ou produzidas por componentes encontrados em certas plantas ou animais.
We had the pleasure of speaking with Curtis Evoy, the supervisor at Allen Gardens Conservatory, to give us some more information about this Toronto oasis and urban jungle. We're here with Curtis Evoy, the supervisor here at Allen Gardens Conservatory. Tell us a little bit about what goes on here and the history behind it.
So Allen Gardens, the park itself is just over 160 years old, and the conservatory is 110 years old. Over the course of the year, we put in four floral shows. So we're just coming up to the end of our winter flower show. January 9th is the last day, and then we start bringing in our spring flowers. So you'll see daffodils and bulbs. So we force spring a little bit early in the conservatory, and so people still have some color to see in this drab winter. Days, and then after that we go into our summer show, then we do a big Japanese mum show in the fall that opens Thanksgiving weekend.
And tell us a little bit about what went into the planning for the winter show.
So we plan the shows a year in advance, so for next year's show it's already planned, so our growers know what they're growing for us for next year's show. So we do a theme usually every year. We have bring in about just over 3,000 poinsettias. So all of our plants come from High Park production greenhouses. So in June, the poinsettias start to come in for next year's show.
And tell us a little bit about some of the greenhouses that are here and what kind of separates them from each other.
So we have 6 greenhouses in total, and they're temperature controlled. So there's a couple different tropical greenhouses. There's an orchid bromeliad house. Then we have a cool house where we have temperate plants, you know, that could take a little bit of frost. So that's our cool greenhouse. Then we have the dome where we have all our bananas and palm trees, and then a cactus and succulent greenhouse. So where you'd find all the arid plants around the world in there.
And what's your favorite greenhouse out of all of them, would you say?
It changes all the time. I don't like to hurt the plants' feelings, so I don't have a favorite. I really like the chrysanthemum show that we put in the fall, but I can't say I have a favorite.
And from everyone that comes here, what's kind of the feedback that you get from everyone that comes through and through the different shows?
So everybody comes for different reasons. A lot of people come for just a slice of meditation or a quiet respite. Lots of school groups come in to learn about plants from around the world. Lots of horticulturalist enthusiasts come in to see the different flowers and different plants. So there's something for everybody, you know. And lots of people that like to try out their new cameras on the plants too.
Hoje ficámos a conhecer as 6 casas verdes, ou como se diz por aqui, 6 greenhouses.
There were many tropical plants and flowers from all over the world, and we were so lucky to see them today.
Estamos ansiosos pelos eventos de primavera que vos vamos trazer muito em breve.